Britain has the most extraordinary places to escape to.
What the actual?
Yeah,
it's gorgeous.
Now I've been given the keys to unlock some of the best. When they work, that is.
Hello?
What's more, I get to take four fabulous women I've been longing to spend time with on the journey.
I told you it was going to be a glamorous weekend. I didn't know you were going to get a white moustache, but, you know.
Oh, my gosh.
Together, we will take you on a slow wander through our country's most tranquil landscapes.
It's an absolute cliché, but they are like God's cathedrals.
And the properties that make the most of them.
Is that not one of the most stunning things you've ever seen?
I'm not diving for my langoustines. Deliveroo! Deliveroo!
We'll explore remarkable architecture.
It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful.
Daring designs.
Holy. I love it. I love it.
And historic wonders.
Wow!
All places offering glorious sanctuary. So please, come with us to breathe the fresh air.
Oh, mushrooms!
Shut out the world.
I love this room.
Reconnect with nature. And each other.
The minute I met you, I thought, oh, yeah, we're good.
And we'll be friends forever.
Oh!
And I will, of course, come armed with plenty of fascinating facts.
I've got a great story about Napoleon's penis.
What?
This time, I'm spending my mini break with acting royalty. From Pamela to Pride and Prejudice. Everybody loves Alison Steadman. But she loves nothing more than the great outdoors.
When I see those clouds, I hear dum da 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 da.
So I'm taking her to the wilds of Suffolk.
Oh, look at this.
So, if you go for an extraordinary escape, what are you looking for? What's the kind of thing?
I love countryside.
Yeah.
I love wildlife. Any creature, I see a rabbit, a hare, I go berserk because I love them so much.
I may have picked perfectly then for my first getaway with Alison. This stunning landscape of shingle beaches and never-ending fields is the Devon Peninsula on the coast of Suffolk.
There's 50 miles of coastline in Suffolk,
yeah.
And it's an area of outstanding natural beauty, but you don't even need to be told that, do you?
That's just amazing.
See it.
Yeah.
And the thing I love about it is it's also packed, packed, packed with history. Look out there,
yeah.
Right? The biggest thing that the British feared, so we're talking about the early part of the 19th century, was the French arriving, okay?
Yes.
Terrified. So
yes.
Talk about Napoleonic times.
Yeah.
They'd beaten Napoleon at the Battle of Trafalgar in 1805, but
yeah,
they still thought he might come because he wasn't somebody who gave up.
Right.
So they decided to build 100 Martello towers all along the coastline. There is one of your extraordinary escapes.
You're kidding?
No. I've put you in a tower like Rapunzel.
What?
Yeah. Come on.
I'm excited.
Found Tower is one of the few remaining Martello towers built along the southern and eastern coasts of England. After lying derelict for over a century, industrial designer Duncan Jackson spent a decade transforming this one into a place where Alison and I are going to put our feet up.
It's amazing, but it doesn't look very habitable.
What, you don't look very sure?
Well, it kind of looks a bit scruffy.
750,000 bricks to build that, roughly.
Really?
How dare
you? How many?
750.
Are you sure about that?
I counted every single one of them.
Well, I'm intrigued, I suppose, is the phrase.
Such a damning word, isn't it? I'm intrigued. But you have to imagine what it was built for. It was built for defence. They were worried that they'd be looking that way out to sea and the French would be sneaky, go along the coast and come in the back door.
Ah.
Right? So the door was put very high up and there was a ladder, and you'd go up inside and pull the ladder back up, and the French would arrive and go, "Zut alors, there is no ladder. What will we do now?"
Oh.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Oh.
Anyway, let's invade, shall we? Shall
let's
you and
invade.
I invade?
Right. And we haven't got to climb up a wooden ladder to
no,
that
I
door?
No, I had this put in for you.
Yeah, thanks. That's
okay.
Very kind.
Prepare to be surprised.
Okay.
Come and look at this.
I mean, it's almost
wow.
Sort of cathedral-like, isn't it? I love the light coming in. Look, you can see the sea on both sides.
It's amazing. Wow, look at that view.
I know.
The sea and the shingle beach and the... Oh, my goodness.
It's beautiful.
It's stunning. It's absolutely beautiful.
The building really does take your breath away. Its extraordinary interior spans three floors, with each of them intricately designed to complement the tower's original curves.
So if you come round here, you can see that everything had to be bespoke in order to follow the sweep of the building.
Yeah.
I mean, it's almost like being on an old-fashioned merry-go-round, isn't it? It's just got all... the excitement. I just think architecturally it's one of the most intriguing buildings I've ever been in.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's absolutely stunning.
And, look
and how did they get this piano in here? That's what I want
yeah,
to
Yeah, I
know.
Think the soldiers had a piano anyway. That's my guess.
Look at this! Log fire!
I know. And even oh. these, the log stores, had to be specially made because of the round walls.
Yeah.
Isn't that wonderful?
They get this gorgeous
it's
silver!
There you go! You're going to be all right
oh.
here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah, are you acting?
I'm not now? Acting.
No.
I'm not.
No.
I'm really loving it. Oh, this is nice.
I'm a big believer that you can feel history in a building. And I feel like you can feel the years of work it would have taken to make this beautiful thing.
Yeah. I honestly would never have thought it would be as beautiful as this.
So look here, this is where the original flooring would have been. Can you see there's a sort of
oh,
a
yes.
wooden ledge there? So up to 25 soldiers would have lived on this floor. It doesn't surprise me, boys.
On this floor?
I mean, I couldn't imagine the smell.
Maybe they had some wet wipes. And
wet wipes?
Yeah.
The old 1810 wet wipes,
yeah,
which were so popular.
They were amazing. They were amazing, those wet wipes.
Those very same soldiers would have watched for the enemy from the tower's roof. Space that has been transformed into an open-plan living area uniquely protected from the elements.
Check this out.
Oh, ho, ho, yes.
That's worth the climb, isn't it?
God, it's amazing.
Yeah. Look at this roof. It's astonishing, isn't
amazing.
It? And it's built of a kind of laminated plywood to make it light enough to go on top of the tower, but it's like strong as concrete. They had to build it twice to get it exactly right.
Oh, it's lovely.
Yeah. See the sofa, specially designed, and he forgot to make it fit through the door. I know. That's
brilliant.
Bring it in by crane.
By crane?
Yeah. And this, there's three of these. There's one there, and one over in the kitchen.
Yeah.
That's where the cannon would have been. So the guys are up here looking out,
right.
Making sure you're not under attack.
Enough of the history. A welcome hamper awaits, and it's full of goodies from local producers.
Oh, that's nice. That is a raw milk artisan cheese made by the Fen...
Oh, God.
Oh, no, has that put you off now?
Tastes so much better up here with the views,
yeah.
Doesn't it?
Are you a chef? Do you like cooking?
I like cooking. I don't cook as much as I used to, but I do like it.
I've never had a round kitchen, but don't you think it'd be really easy to cook
what,
and
to
have
cook.
Everything kind of there? Just
look at this.
A little dance. I think it's lovely.
Yeah, I do. It is. It's beautiful.
Very like the sort of place you would have holidayed as a child, yes?
No.
Oh, not at all. Not at all.
No, I think I only remember going on two holidays.
OK.
Yeah, and that was one to Llandudno in North Wales, which was beautiful.
Yeah.
And one to the Isle of Man. And I remember watching the TT race and Geoff Duke was one of the top cyclists and I thought it was the Duke of Edinburgh because I heard the word Duke and I thought, oh, that must be the Duke,
Duke of Edinburgh on his motorcycle.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah, but they were lovely holidays. But why not so many?
Because...
Well, my parents didn't have the money. They didn't have the money to go on holiday. We had a nice garden, you know, so holidays were fun. And they were nice, and my parents were lovely. You know, it was always a happy time, but we just didn't go away to exotic places.
Ooh, that's nice.
Ah.
Right.
Wow, the sea. Oh, all around, all around, all around. Oh, look.
What is
that? Look at those clouds. I love clouds.
It's like being in the clouds.
They're so beautiful. And they change all the time. You can look away for 1 minute, you look back, and they've changed again. And to me, it's like sometimes I can see a city over there, you know, in the clouds. Oh, I just love it. I mean, we've no control over these clouds. We've no control over the weather, the wind, you know what I mean? It just happens, and as human beings, we have to just stand there and go, wow, look at this. It just takes me to another place.
Yeah. I like the names of them. I like Cirrus and Cumulonimbus and all of the names. But it is like a sort of ever-changing story, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. I take photographs of clouds all the time. I saw a cloud a few weeks ago. White cloud, just and a completely blue sky, and it was in the shape of a heart. Ah, iPad was out taking pictures, you know, it was just so nice. Yeah, over here, where these clouds are dark, what I do in my head is I play music.
Oh,
when I see those clouds, I hear dum da 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 da
da da da da da. They can be so dramatic, can't they? Do you come from a dramatic family?
Nope. My parents always encouraged me. I loved acting from when I was tiny, tiny.
And they didn't say to you, oh, for goodness sake, that's not a proper job. So...
No, they said the opposite. They said, go for it.
But to me, you... I mean, without, you know, blowing smoke up your what's not, you're one of my heroes, and you're a star. Do you think of yourself as a star?
No. No. I'm just grateful to have been able to spend all my working life acting, you know, and I think I've had a lot of luck. And I've loved it. I've loved every minute of it. And I'm so grateful to be working now at my age.
I remember my dad used to tell me when I was little, he said, oh, age is just a state of mind, and I used to think it was nonsense, he was old. But now I agree with him. I'm old enough to go, oh, yeah, I still feel about 12 inside.
Me too. That's the joy of life. You know, you've got to keep being silly.
Darling, I've made an entire career out of being silly.
We could watch the clouds all day. Well, Alison could. But there are bedrooms to be found. Three of them on the ground floor.
I think this might be the room for you. OK. So, they used to keep the gunpowder in here. It's an explosive sort of room. And there was always light coming in through. See, that's now it's frosted glass, but there was always light. Why do you think that might have been? That they had a window through to the gunpowder?
Window through to the gunpowder? I don't know. I don't know, miss.
So if it was dark, nobody came in and went, oh, it's a bit dark in here, and lit a match.
Oh, right. Yeah, their pipe or whatever.
Yeah, just...
Gonna have a quiet pipe.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
The solution for today's guests was to drill shafts through the 3-metre-thick walls to bring light from the outdoors in. But there's nothing quite like getting out there and experiencing this extraordinary location for yourself.
That Prosecco is nice and cold.
It's going to be delicious. In Denmark, it's New Year's Eve, we put our ski clothes on and go outside for a barbecue.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you're mad.
Well, there may be an element of that, obviously.
This is our beach. There's nobody here except us. I just like to see places I've never seen before.
Yes,
I've never been here before on this beach. It's brilliant.
Yep. Here we go.
Woo! Whoa!
Coming at you. There you go, my friend.
Thank you.
So, if you were working, if you were making a film or something, how would you relax if you had a day off?
Oh, walking. You know, I'd find an open space, or if I was in a city, I always go to the art gallery. I love that.
Yeah, me too.
Every city in the UK has got brilliant paintings in every gallery, and so there's always something to look at. That's why I love being on tour with the play, because you go around all these amazing cities.
It's just so lovely. In Denmark, we would think this weather was fine.
I don't mind the weather, actually. I mean, as long as there's birds around and, you know, the sea and the sky, and as long as you've got the right gear on, I think it's great.
I've got a great story I wanted to tell you about Napoleon's penis.
What?
Yeah. So when he died, 1820...
Napoleon's penis?
Yeah. When he died, the doctor did the autopsy, cut off his penis and gave it to a priest. The penis did the rounds of private collectors, right? And in 1977, it was bought by a New York urologist for $3,000. They decided to value it at $1,000 per half inch. It was only an inch and a half. And apparently it looks like beef jerky. The man used to keep it under his bed. I mean, that is how the mighty are fallen. That's all I'm saying to you.
OK, well, that image I shall keep with me for quite a long time. Cheers. Here's looking at you, kid.
And to you. Oh, lungfuls of that air.
Yeah.
Isn't that good?
Nice. Sunshine!
I know. Sunshine and wilderness is what I'm going to give you today. So there are acres and acres of fabulous flower meadow. 125 species of bird here. 600 species of moth.
No.
Yeah.
You're lying.
No, and I think moths are amazing. So,
so do I.
Yeah. Oh, great. Okay.
I love them.
Look at this. Cornflowers.
It's still like summer here.
I love a wildflower meadow. I've ventured with my nature-loving friend, Alison Steadman, north from Suffolk's coast to a place with a promising name, Wilderness Reserve, where deep in 5,000 acres sits our next tranquil escape. I wanted you to have somewhere classic Suffolk to stay.
Right.
So we're going to stay in this stunning cottage.
Wow! Oh, that's nice. It's beautiful.
Yeah,
it really
it's
is
stunning.
A gorgeous house.
Picture postcard, the thatched roof and distinctive ruddled ochre walls of this cottage are all part of a loving 3-year restoration by its owners to reinstate its 17th century charm.
Oh, now look, the little place you can sit there by the water. It's like Monet.
It is like Monet.
Lovely Monet bridge.
But even more unusual, this cottage has its very own moat, harbouring guests away from the world.
A moat?
It's a moat, all the way round.
Oh! Ah!
Isn't it fantastic?
That's brilliant!
So the moat is for practical reasons, really. Moat cottages made in the old-fashioned way, which is daub and wattle, they used to call it. It was strips of wood and then you back it up with clay.
Right.
And the clay was dug out here, used to build the house, and then you get a fresh water supply, you get a place where you can keep fish, and it looks posh. It's like having a castle. Oh, I've got a bit of a moat.
Right,
it's one
a protective
up,
moat.
It's one up on the neighbours to have a moat.
Right, yeah. Okay.
So I need you to walk with a little bit of pride towards your cottage.
With purpose.
Yes, with purpose. Ooh. Let's both do, oh, look at my marvellous cottage.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, yes.
Wonderful.
Oh, look, a house over there with no moat. They must be sad.
Dear, poor darling.
your bicycle?
No.
Okay. That'll just be me then.
I'll sit in the basket. What is it about thatch? As soon as you see thatch, yeah, you go, oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
I can't wait to get inside.
Right. In
Come
you go,
on.
My lovely.
Yes, let's go.
Nice.
Yes.
Nice.
Oh, it's gorgeous. And look at the views.
That is fantastic. Oh, we'll settle in here.
I think so.
Yes.
The restored 17th century features with sumptuous modern touches instantly make you feel welcome. The owners stripped out boards, plaster and fittings, uncovering original beams of ancient oak and a 300-year-old timber wall frame in the oldest parts of the house, before renovating and modernising the home for their 21st century guests.
So that bit there, that's a modern extension, but don't you think it's brilliant how it just flows
Is
through?
It?
Yeah.
Is that...
Yeah, they added that on.
Wow.
Even the windows, they took the pattern off the existing windows and tried to replicate it so that it just really sits
really?
Properly.
Yeah.
It's beautiful,
no,
isn't it?
It's great.
Come into the sitting room. Hey.
Nice.
It's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm not sure the sofa's big enough. I mean, for two, what do you reckon? It's not quite, not quite large enough.
Oh, I'll sleep there tonight. Yeah.
Look at the floorboards from above. Isn't it stunning?
But before we get too comfortable indoors, an escape here is as much about the expansive, isolated outdoors.
If you owned a field like this, what would you do with it?
Oh, I don't know.
Sheep.
I've got horses.
Horses?
Some little ponies, yeah.
Aww.
Oh, they're so gorgeous, and they're thick, woolly coats, you know, and you're just giving them a scrunch and a cuddle. It's so nice.
That'd be a thing to keep in London, wouldn't it? A little tiny pony.
Look!
Oh! Mushrooms!
Well, well, well.
Yes, well. Be careful, don't step on them.
Wow.
So this will look a fairy ring.
Hello, mushrooms. Yeah. Oh, my God, I love mushrooms so much. Well, fungi. They're not mushrooms, are they?
You know Beatrix Potter?
Yeah.
She was actually expert
oh, look,
on,
more.
On fungi.
Oh, was she really?
Yes, she was, yeah.
I got my iPad. I've got so many pictures of mushrooms on my iPad. It's
Is that
ridiculous.
A thing? Do you take but pictures of mushrooms?
Oh God, yeah, all the time. Lovely. I love fungi. Love fungi. I mean, the most exciting thing was a few weeks ago. I was walking and I found this fungi, and you know, red with the white dots on.
Oh yes.
I was in heaven, absolute heaven. Maybe comes from childhood. I don't know. Fairies. You know, the stories behind mushrooms and all that, and the fact that it's, you know, just one day they suddenly pop up. I love it. I love the clouds. Look at that. I've got to take that cloud, sorry.
Can I just say you've not taken a single picture of me in the entire trip? It's just mushrooms and clouds.
It has got to be cup of tea o'clock in the kitchen, where a thoughtful welcome always awaits guests.
Oh, look.
Oh, gosh, that looks good. Cake, tea already.
Fantastic.
Fruit.
I do know about cake. Let's have a look at the crumb texture.
That looks good.
I can do that.
I think actually, that looks very good. OK, thank you very much.
It's a pleasure, Trej.
Whoa! Look, a real milk bottle.
That made you happy?
No plastic. When I was a kid, I remember the cream on the top of the bottle there. Yeah. My mum used to say, we'll have cream off the top of the bottle with strawberries when it was...
Nice.
When we had strawberries, which was a fortnight in the year, just before Wimbledon, usually. Yeah. Oh, there we are.
A Victoria sponge, homemade, and tea.
But it's so nice, isn't it, that they thought about this?
I know.
Cos you suddenly feel, oh, yes, I'm at home here. Fire, tea, cake. I mean, it's a bit special. OK.
Do you think the table's big enough?
Just about.
Do you remember that time we stayed at... What was his name? Princess Diana's brother's house.
Oh, Charles Spencer.
Charles Spencer's house. Yeah. How big was that table? Seriously, I don't want to exaggerate. How big was that table?
Oh, well, it was at least, I would say, four times as long as this.
It was ridiculous.
Yeah. I arrived about 12:30. I'm got in this amazing house, and then someone said to me, right, if you'd like to go through, you can have lunch. You know, so I thought, oh, that'd be nice.
Nice, yeah.
Dumped my bags, went in, and this view, I mean, a bit like this view, amazing. Just, you know, beautiful trees, fields, flowers everywhere. And I was sitting and I suddenly realised, how lucky am I?
What's the poshest thing you've ever been invited to?
Well, it sounds like I'm showing off if I say this.
No, I asked you.
I think it was the Queen invited various people for drinks, and Her Majesty came through, walked through the room where the rock band was, and her equerry was standing behind her, and he just looked at me and he went... I thought, oh, I mean, she's coming over to me. And he said, Mum, this is the actress, Alison Steadman. And she went... Aren't the microphones loud nowadays? And I said, yes, they are.
Yeah.
And with that, she moved on.
That was it?
That was my big moment.
Enough. It's a funny life, isn't it? Casual story about meeting the Queen and stuff. Did you ever think that was going to be how things were for you?
No. When I was a child, the coronation, for me, was such an exciting time. And the idea that I one day actually meet Her Majesty and... You know, that was just ridiculous. I never dreamed that could come true. Oh, I could be happy here. I really could be happy.
Well, it's just as well we're staying then.
Yeah.
Deep in the Suffolk countryside, Alison Steadman and I have settled nicely into our 17th century cottage. Renovated for 21st century guests. It's the only cottage I've stayed in with its own moat. I mean, there's posh.
Hey, but effectively, you're on your own island here. Look, got the moat all the way around.
With such a vast estate promising nature on our doorstep, it would be positively rude not to wrap up and venture out again.
Look at that view. 5,000 acres that you can explore.
Really?
If you come and stay in the house. It's a little bit windy.
Yes.
Though I've not seen your hair look as nice as that for a long time.
Really? Yeah.
I mean, you're rocking that.
It's a shabby chic look, yeah.
Yeah, look. Boris or Donald, I can't decide. And look at this decorative work. It's done by a local craftswoman. Isn't it fantastic?
I love this.
Yeah. Look at the birds.
The bird there, yes. Oh.
It's called pargeting, and it was during the reign of Elizabeth I, in the 1500s, that birds and foliage became all the rage when it came to decorating buildings.
I love that, all the oak leaves and acorns along there.
Oh, look, hidden in there, I think it's like a little cat sleeping. Can you see that? Look, here.
Oh, yes! Or is it a little
mouse? Is it a mouse?
It's a mouse, and he's holding an acorn.
That's fantastic. See the dovecote up there? It's fake.
Yeah.
Like, doves keep turning up and going, what is that? What is that?
Thought I'd found a house.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Constantly, like that, going, rubbish.
Kids must love this, discovering all these little things, mustn't they?
Look, boating.
Boating?
Yeah.
Sunday.
Yeah. It's boating weather, come on.
I'm not.
No, I'm mad for boating. It's going to be great.
No, oh God, mind you don't slip.
No, it's
going to
be great.
Really muddy and slippy.
Do you want to come?
No.
Oh, it's quite tricky to get in.
Yeah. Do you want a hand? Yeah.
Got this.
Whoa.
Boom. I'm in.
And that was the last we saw of her.
Yeah, never seen again. This is lovely.
Is it? You're an expert, obviously. Where did you learn rowing?
Well, I'm Danish. The whole of Denmark is just one series of islands.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
We always had boats as a kid.
Yeah.
My dad taught me to sail. I love it. Oh, I am never happier than when I'm on a boat.
Hey, well done.
It was fantastic.
You
I'm so
did it.
Happy. I'm Admiral of the Moat. I loved it. Loved it, loved it, loved it.
Cheers, well done. Well done.
Mud in your eye.
Mud in your eye.
There is something about water. The minute I'm near it, suddenly I'm relaxed and smiling and happy.
Yeah.
I love it, I absolutely.
Yeah.
Love it.
I love the fish in here before. Yeah. There's so many of them, dozens and dozens of them. Oh, there's one there now.
Whiling away the hours feels all part of the experience here, but if we're going to stay the night, we need to find our bedrooms. And we have six to choose from.
Come on up.
OK.
And see if you like your room.
OK.
I don't know if you should mind your head. I mean, I won't have to.
Ooh! Woo-hoo!
Is it nice? What's it like?
Got this amazing bath.
Oh, yeah?
It's beautiful.
I'm just going to unpack.
And I've got stairs. I don't know what's up there.
Trying to keep my feet off the clean bed.
What's going to watch your head? I've got a toilet.
Good to know. Did you get your suitcase delivered?
Oh, yes, thank you.
Great.
Yep,
mine's enormous. There's a lot of unpacking. I'm going to be quite busy for a bit.
OK. I've got a swan in my fireplace, OK?
Is that a euphemism?
No, it's true.
While this escape is very much about getting back to nature, the team here do like to accompany said nature with a touch of utter luxury. A private alfresco bar. Yes, please.
Wow, look at this fire.
Hi there.
Nice to meet you.
Georgia,
Alison,
Sandy.
This one's Chuck over here.
Hi, Chuck. How are you doing?
Hello, Chuck. Wonderful.
Ooh. Can we get you guys some drinks?
Yes.
We have a lot. So we have hot chocolate, mulled wine.
Did you say mulled wine?
I did, yeah. Would you like some?
Oh, please. I'd love some mulled wine.
We'll have a couple of them, please.
Oh, lovely. Thank you. Lovely.
No,
oh, that's great.
How marvellous. Yeah.
Mm.
So I'm just going to...
Well, it's very, very delicious.
There for you.
Oh, it's a proper whittling knife.
Have you ever carved or whittled a spoon before?
No.
No, not a spoon, but I have whittled a bird once.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Wow, what bird did you whittle?
Well, it's hard to say, frankly, when it was finished.
What was it supposed to be?
Well, it was somewhere between a robin and a swan.
Fantastic.
How should we begin?
So, holding the knife with a nice strong fist,
yeah,
with your thumb wrapped around and the blade always facing away from you, rest our knife elbow on our knee, and our left hand is the one that pulls backwards.
Oh, I see. Okay. Can I just say that in this moment I'm entirely happy?
Yay!
I can't think of anything nicer.
I know.
To sit and do
mulled wine.
Yeah, learning
cutting
a new
a
skill.
A fire.
I know. And while you're doing this, you can't really think about anything else, can you?
All I'm thinking about is the spoon.
It's perfect.
Now that you know, I'm not thinking about any worries or what's going to happen later or tomorrow or.
That's
it's
ideal.
Just in the moment.
We often find with our guests, sort of the first day or two, they all just seem really rush, rush, rush.
Yeah.
Quite stressed and worried about this and worried about that. And as soon as they immerse themselves, you see them honestly decompress before your eyes.
I'm de-stressed. I've only been here 10 minutes.
Wow, perfect. There you go.
I'm a bit of a birder.
Oh, yeah. Really? Lovely.
Well, it's mainly garden birds, obviously, because I live
okay.
in London, but put the feeders up, you know. And to me, when I'm eating my breakfast and I look at the feeder and I see the birds coming in and out, it's like having friends out there.
Yeah, definitely.
And if the feeder's empty and I go and have a breakfast, I think, oh, no, my friends are now. And I get the seeds and rush out and fill up the feeder because, you know, it just makes me feel better. Cheers, Sandy. Cheers.
Oh, yeah, forgot about my drink.
I'm just going to leave you to continue to carve your spoons.
OK.
Thank you, Chuck.
Yeah, thank you, Chuck. OK, I'm a bit peckish.
Do you want a sausage?
In a word, yeah.
OK.
Now, we've got to use these things, yeah?
Yeah. You pierce a sausage, then I'll come and get one.
OK. Like that?
Yeah. You go first.
You've done this before?
I have. It's not my first sausage. I don't know if I should say that out loud. Oh, that's perfect, that is.
Mmm, good sausage.
Do you know what? I've been to some of the finest restaurants in the world. I'd rather be here. Here with
Me
you.
Too.
Here with you, 100%. Cooking a sausage and having a hot wine.
Cheers.
Cheers, my friend. It's our final day in beautiful Suffolk. And I'm taking Alison south, past the village of Butley, and on to a home where I've promised her a divine experience with historic connections. I think it's fair to say, which possibly you've realised, that I am obsessed with history.
Mm-hmm.
So, what's the most famous moment in history in England that probably every child knows about?
Well, Battle of Hastings?
Battle of Hastings, OK. You probably even know the date.
1066.
1066, OK.
I feel like I'm in school.
No, that's fantastic, right? So,
yeah.
Imagine this. William the Conqueror had a commander of archers called de Glanville. And de Glanville's grandson, Ranulf, must have been under a lot of pressure to do something special because he had this incredibly famous grandfather. So in 1171, he decided to found a priory. Butley Priory, where we are now, we are at a place that is that closely connected to William the Conqueror. Do you not think that's astonishing?
Yeah, that is astonishing.
The priory originally comprised of a magnificent collection of buildings spanning 20 acres. Today, only the ornate 14th century gatehouse remains. Here, the poor received food and money while travellers were offered hospitality. What I love is that all those hundreds of years later, we are coming for exactly the same purpose.
It's wonderful.
It's not too shabby, is it?
Oh, it's great. And look at the faces at the top and the lion and...
So there would have been up there, originally, the Virgin Mary.
Yeah.
And then on either side of her, Gabriel. And then ran off to Glanville because he was... You know,
yeah,
up with the good guys. Famous in his time. Actually, lots of famous people have stayed here. Bill Wyman stayed here. the Arctic Monkeys. And I heard, I don't know if it's true, I'd have to check it out, Alison Steadman, as I'm just about I heard.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, apparently so. So I thought what we could do was staying somewhere sort of small and cozy, intimate. I was thinking, but instead I booked this.
Wow! Oh, it's amazing! It's beautiful.
So this is the gatehouse of the priory. You have to imagine that the priory would have been down that way. You would arrive on your horse, and you wish to go and see the prior, and so immediately you think, oh, I wonder if they'll let me in. I'll knock on the porter's door, OK? So, that's the porter's door over there. But I need you to imagine 1320s, you're a very fine gentleman, and you want some religious solace, OK? I'll be right back.
Where are you going?
Go and knock on the door. Where's your horse? Oh, OK. Hello?
Hello.
We don't want any. We've had it today. We don't want nothing.
Oh, I see. No. Yeah. Oh, you're my sister, aren't you?
We've both gone for the same voice.
Yes.
I thought you were like a man who...
No, dear,
no.
No, no. No, the man's over there sitting in his carriage with right. the two four horses.
You want to see the prior?
Yeah, he wants to stay the night.
Stay the night?
Yeah,
that'll be dear. That'll be very expensive. Right, I'll see what I can do.
All right.
The gatehouse wasn't always this grand. For two centuries it lay decaying before a passionate individual rescued it, saving these stunning features for future guests to enjoy.
This ceiling is 1320s.
Wow.
Do you not think that's incredible? All of the life that must have passed underneath this structure.
Well, I love it. And it's the way it's light everywhere. Everywhere's beautifully painted. I look at every detail of all this stonework, and I just like to imagine who it was who made it.
Mm.
And that's what they've left for us for hundreds of years. It's extraordinary.
I feel the calm in religious buildings. I really like the sense of peace.
I do like going in churches, though. I was in a play in the West End once, and I was quite stressed. I used to go in the French church.
Oh, I know, yeah.
In Soho. Mm. And I would just sit for an hour between matinee and an evening show. And it really used to calm me and relax me. And I loved it.
I think it does all of us good to just step off our daily lives for a minute and just sit and be quiet.
As we explore the very grand upstairs, it seems just the faintest whiff of Baroque bedroom decor is all it takes to bring out the period drama actress in Alison.
Ooh!
Hey.
Very spacious. Do I look good with the light behind me?
Oh, darling, look at you.
She may very well pass for 42 in the dusk with the light behind her.
I think that's great. Do you like doing the ones where you have to dress up posh and old-fashioned?
I like doing Pride and Prejudice. That was a nice period thing.
Did you have to wear a corset?
Yes. That wasn't good.
No. But what is it that you like about it? Is it that dressing up thing, isn't it?
Well, it is. It's fun. I like to... The idea that one minute you can be doing a present-day drama and the next minute you can do a period, that's what's the fun of acting, you know? I mean...
Was there a moment when you were at school and you thought, I'm gonna do this for a living?
Well, I do remember I was in a play at school. Not a very good one, you know, we were just messing about. I was only about 8. And I can remember overhearing the teacher saying to my mother, you know, Alison could be an actress. She's very good. And I thought, oh, I could be an actress. You know.
And that was it? It's just glanced at
I kind of realised it was... That's what I liked doing. I did like acting. I did like pretending to be other people, doing stupid voices. And I seriously think that kicked it off, yeah.
You know, I don't want you to be without grandeur, Lady Stedman. Look at this ceiling. Isn't that magnificent?
Oh, wow. Oh, and I love the chandelier.
Oh. Shall I have one sent to your flat?
Please. Half the size.
Understated. And even though it's got this tremendous vaulted ceiling and so on, you sit here in front of the fire and I think you just feel relaxed.
Yeah. So many log fires.
I know. I've been very busy. Matches everywhere. Now, I'm going to go into that cupboard.
What?
Yeah. Right, 2 seconds, just get myself ready. Okay.
Well, but it just looks like a cupboard. I love it, sir.
Bar. It's great, isn't it? So, the thing I want to show you, not really the bar, this. This is the only remaining piece from the actual priory. So, this is 1171. And, I mean, I'm touching it, it's amazing. Also, they keep in the Angostura bitters on it, which is a bit weird. And this bit here, this is where the priest, or the prior, would have washed his hands. It's
all right, little sink.
I've been told it's called a piscina, but that doesn't sound very nice, does it?
A what?
A piscina. I thought it meant swimming pool, and it's
I mean, even for me, it's a bit small for that.
But what is perfect in size is our end of trip G&T to toast our wonderful adventure.
Hey, come on, come on, come on.
Come on. Yes, cheers.
It's looking at you, kid.
Which was the most extraordinary escape?
I must say, today, when we walked into the main room there, the gatehouse, and it does take your breath away, when you look up, amazing stonework and the way it's been adapted to modern times, you know, and not spoiled, but enhanced. You know, it's that thing of one minute you think, oh, this is the best.
Yeah.
Then the next minute you think, well, actually, the Martell Tower was amazing.
And then you think,
when we climbed up on that wall, the view...
It was fantastic, wasn't it?
Was amazing. And I just kept thinking, oh, to see this wildlife, the changing of the seasons, the sea and, well, of course, the clouds, you know. I mean, it's just... If you live in London, suddenly to be in that open space is so wonderful.
Well, I thought you turned out to be rather good at whittling.
Do you know, I love the whittling.
Did you?
I did love... because I love the fire. And I didn't want to leave.
I've just loved hanging out with you. Thank you.
Well, I've loved hanging out with you. Thank you.
To me, pal.
It's been a good laugh.
I was just thinking, as it used to be a priory, I wonder if we should do, like, a moment's vow of silence. We could try.
Try?
Yeah. All right. Here we go.
Are we doing it?
Next time,
wow.
Actress Jessica Hines and I...
This is my absolute dream, what's happening right now.
...explore some extraordinary escapes in the southeast of England. As we step back in time...
I say, oh, hello, farmer. I'm Dusty Miller.
...get down with nature...
Seems to have silenced them.
...and hit the beach.
Yes! Yes! No!
And if you can't wait to lose yourself in more idyllic parts of our island, you can stream all episodes of Extraordinary Escapes with Sandy Toksvig on All 4 now. And Sandy's work doesn't end there. She's helping adults turn their literacy lives around in the write-offs, available to stream on All 4 as well. Britain's most expensive houses is next.